The end of the 19th century saw the rise of a movement thoroughly hostile to the underlying principles of the nation's founding, the Progressive Movement. Although I argued in Liberty and Tyranny, Ameritopia, and elsewhere that the term statist better describes the left and its multifarious ideological forms and manifestations, it is impossible to decipher, unravel, and highlight certain aspects of the progressive history and influence on Americanism, and reference at some length its ideological founders and activists without referring to it and them by the usual and accepted term. Therefore, for the purposes of this program, I must do so out of convenience and necessity, albeit reluctantly. Progressivism was imported from Europe and would result in a radical break from America's heritage. In fact, it is best described as an elitist-driven counter-revolution to the American Revolution, in which the sovereignty of the individual, natural rights, natural law, and the civil society, built on a foundation of thousands of years of enlightened thinking and human experience, would be drastically altered and even abandoned for an ideological agenda broadly characterized as historical progress. Progressivism is the idea of the inevitability of historical progress and the perfectibility of man and his self-realization through the national community or collective. While its intellectual and political advocates clothe its core in populist terminology, and despite the existence of democratic institutions and cyclical voting, progressivism's emphasis on material egalitarianism and societal engineering and its insistence on concentrated, centralized administrative rule lead inescapably to varying degrees of autocratic governance. Moreover, for progressives, there are no absolute or permanent truths, only passing and distant historical events. Thus, even values are said to be relative to time and circumstances. There is no eternal moral order. That is, what was good and true in 1776 and before is not necessarily true and good today. Consequently, the very purpose of America's founding is debased. To better understand this ideology, its refutation of the American heritage, and its enormous effect on modern American life, it is necessary to become acquainted with some of the most influential progressive intellectuals who, together with others, set the nation on this course. Given their prolific writings, it is neither possible nor necessary to delve into every manner of their thoughts or the differences among them in their brand of progressivism. For our purposes, it is enough to expose essential aspects of their arguments. Herbert Croly, 1869-1930, was among the leading academic and progressive thinkers. Croly co-founded the magazine The New Republic and authored The Promise of American Life, 1909, an essential book among his fellow intellectuals, jurists, and certain powerful politicians, including Theodore Roosevelt. Among other things, Croly argued that to conceive the better American future as a consummation which will take care of itself, as the necessary result of our customary conditions, institutions, and ideas, persistence in such a conception is admirably designed to deprive American life of any promise at all. The better future which Americans propose to build is nothing if not an idea which must in certain essential respects emancipate them from their past. American history contains much matter for pride and congratulation and much matter for regret and humiliation. Americans must be prepared to sacrifice to that traditional vision even the traditional American ways of realizing it. Such a sacrifice is, I believe, coming to be demanded, and unless it is made, American life will gradually cease to have any specific promise. Hence, the American heritage and founding principles must be thrust aside if there is to be human progress. They are dismissed as outmoded and obstructive, for they are unconnected to the present. Man, society, and the political and governing systems must be pliable to meet the special conditions of the day, subject to the commands of a consolidated and amalgamated ruling class. This requires a far-reaching change in education, the culture, and the American mindset. In particular, the sacred rights of the individual, paramount under the Declaration of Independence's order, are said to be an old notion of individualism. They must give way to the new individualism, where the individual is subjugated to the mortal power of the state in the name of the general will and greater good.
Bono, audio ebook doc site.